The study we're about to look at is incredible. What are we looking at primarily? We're looking at actually reversing the aging process. So you probably want to consider this more of a proof of concept study per se, for two primary reasons. One is the aging was accelerated through basically the depletion of mitochondrial DNA. So the second thing is we're looking at too, is that by replenishing mitochondrial DNA, the aging process that was caused by that depletion of DNA or mitochondrial dysfunction reversed. And I want to use a strong word term that, reversed. And you'll understand why in a second. So we're not looking at slowing down the aging process. We're looking, in the case of at least mitochondrial DNA depletion, which is also part of the intrinsic aging process, that yes, some aspects hold the potential, hypothetically, to actually be reversed itself. In this case, hair and skin issues in regard to age, wrinkles, and hair loss. With that in mind, let's proceed. Also, too, as just a slight warning, there will be, this is a mouse model, so there will be a picture of a mouse. An older mouse, looking like a younger mouse eventually, but nothing weird or gross. But I just want to give you a heads up anyways. So to proceed as follows. Scientists reverse aging-associated skin wrinkles and hair loss in a mouse model. A gene mutation causes wrinkled skin and hair loss. Turning off the mutation restores the mouse to normal appearance. Here is the picture. Or I should say, you see a small picture there? Now we're going to make bigger. All right. This part is amazing. Before and after. We're going to focus on basically the mouse in the middle. So what you see there is after about 2 months of mitochondrial DNA depletion, a normal-looking mouse had the aging accelerated. So they had the wrinkly skin and the hair loss. Now, if you just focus on the outcome itself, does it look like the mouse aged? Yes. Now, just looking at the outcome, do you think wrinkly skin and hair loss can actually be reversed? Well, in this case, in regard to mitochondrial dysfunction and mitochondrial DNA depletion, that mouse you see on the side of the after, it's only 1 month after the mitochondria were restored. Wrinkle skin, hair loss, gone. To state, the same mouse basically right shows reversal of wrinkles and hair loss after 1 month, or I should say as 1 month later, after mitochondrial DNA replication was resumed. You're going to ask for yourself, example in a few seconds, well, how did they deplete that mitochondrial DNA? I'm going to get to that in about a minute. To go into the research as follows, though. That's just amazing. 1 month reversed. That's what I want to say. We're not looking at slowing the aging process. We're looking at actually reversing parts of the aging process itself. But again, I drift. Researchers have reversed wrinkled skin and hair loss, hallmarks of aging in a mouse model. When a mutation leading to mitochondrial dysfunction is induced, the mouse develops wrinkled skin and extensive visible hair loss in a matter of weeks. When the mitochondrial function is restored by turning off the gene responsible for mitochondrial dysfunction, the mouse returns to smooth skin and thick fur indistinguishably from a healthy mouse of the same age. So if you just look at the outcome itself, wrinkles reversed, hair restored, that's your outcome. It happened, there it is. To further quote the researcher, to our knowledge, this observation is unprecedented. Why is this important to humans? To proceed, in humans, the decline of mitochondrial function is seen during aging, and mitochondrial dysfunction can drive age-related diseases. A depletion of the DNA is mitochondria is also implicated in human mitochondrial diseases, cardiovascular disease, diabetes, age-associated neurological disorders, and cancer, which you normally don't think of as in layman terms is a mitochondrial disease. The mouse model, quoting the researcher, should provide an unprecedented opportunity to development of preventive and therapeutic drug development strategies to augment the mitochondrial functions for the treatment of aging-associated skin and hair pathology and other human diseases in which mitochondrial dysfunction plays a significant role. So, replenishing or fixing the mitochondrial dysfunction or replenishing mitochondrial DNA may have the same impact in humans if further trials replicate these particular results in humans. Now, here's an interesting part. How did they create this mitochondrial dysfunction? This part's kind of scary, but it's worth a read. And here we go. The mutation in the mouse model is induced when the antibiotic doxycycline is added to the food or drinking water. This causes depletion of mitochondrial DNA because the enzyme to replicate the DNA becomes inactive. So the antibiotic, in this case, shuts down mitochondrial DNA replication, leading to that. To proceed, in 4 weeks, mice showed gray hair, reduced hair density, hair loss, slowed movements in lethargy, changes that are reminiscent of natural aging. In this case, we're talking like intrinsic aging. Wrinkled skin was seen 4 to 8 weeks after induction of the mutation by the consumption in the water and food of this antibiotic. And females had more severe skin wrinkles than males. Kind of scary, but that's not the point of the research. But to proceed as follows. The wrinkled skin showed changes similar to those seen in both intrinsic and extrinsic aging. Intrinsic aging is a natural process of aging, and extrinsic aging is the effect of external factors that influence aging, such as skin wrinkles that develop from excess sun or long-term smoking. So basically what they're trying to say is that this basically simulated part of the natural aging process, either caused by environmental or by internal. But reversal of the mutation restored mitochondrial function as well as the skin and hair pathology. This showed that mitochondria are reversible regulators of skin aging and hair loss, an observation the researcher said, quote unquote, is surprising. All right, now the DOI will be there as far as links to the full research, which is wonderful because you can dive into the research yourself and not just looking at the abstract, you get an opportunity to look at the full study. And there are amazing tidbits of information in regard to the observations of the researchers themselves. So, in the case of mitochondrial depletion, which happens to individuals potentially over time, again, can those situations be reversed by restoring the mitochondrial DNA due to the mitochondrial dysfunction? Comes fast. At this point in time, in the animal model, that potential may exist in humans as well. Again, Raptor Channel signing off. Links will all be there for you. And thank you much for listening. Thank you very much for listening. I look forward to seeing you all once again in 7 days. Catch you next time. Bye.